ういうこと。現にサティロスだって。サティロスとが一番最近だけど、それでも、326年になるわね。
So as you have just seen, this is what Medusa was gonna say about Seder. I'm going to summarize things and make this quick as to why this is the case. However, I will get this out of the way first. And that would be the line Nezha mentioned. What Nezha is saying is that primals are just primal cores given form by the astrals. What we see them, as in their manifested state, is a product of the core. Primals are also seen as nothing but weapons to the astrals, to further their own plans, and were at first, not a part of mortal society on top of just being creations. A primal is also immutable. Immutable meaning it cannot change. To add on to this, Baldur is a core manifested in the form of a man. Seder is a core manifested in the form of a woman. There are also cores in the form of literal beasts. A core is essentially nothing until it manifests back into the body created for it, and is also a primal's most vulnerable state. Moving right along to the things I seek to speak about in this video, it is after what Nezha said that Medusa mentions the cut-off quote about Seder. However, what Nezha said did not exactly have to do with what Medusa was going to say. Afterwards, Medusa is cut off by Baal, which leads into an argument, and him leaving the group to confront what he felt, which was Geo and Medusa's sisters. As he leaves, he tells Nezha to watch out for Geo. All of this happens in Chapter 3 Part 1. Chapter 3 Part 2 and Chapter 3 Part 3 are as followed. Then Chapter 3 Part 4 happens, and in the midst of that, Vern ends up asking how long Medusa knew Baal, Nezha, and Seder. But on top of this line, that isn't all. Medusa then goes into speaking about Nezha, and gets cut off in the same way as when she was speaking about Seder, and then proceeds to take both situations into account saying that she keeps getting interrupted.
でもそういえば、ナタ君はそれよりも前に…魔物の声!まったく、話の邪魔じゃない!
Medusa then goes on to speak about Nezha, while she is fighting a monster with the crew.So by technicality, the conversation had continued, and Medusa had already spoken about what she wanted to speak about in regards to Seder and Nezha. All of which has to do with the past. Also, her NPC line also involves her past, but most likely a different point in time within it. It mentions of a primal power beyond mortal comprehension. Something a person can't comprehend on sight. It was a line shown about her character after the event.With how Nezha's past was covered in primal resonance in text, to more of it in more context in his Fate episode, and then expanded upon further in the 8th anniversary event. Seder will receive the same treatment for sure. We have already seen some of it, but from Baldur's point of view. It is only a matter of time. Thanks for watching and I hope you've learned something new and have come to fully understand things.